The coming long weekend is shaping up to become one for the history books. Queensland tonight preparing for not one, but two destructive weather events. Tropical cyclone Kirrily is on track to form in just hours and make landfall just in time for Australia Day. The southeast next in the firing line, facing a potential flood disaster. Our reporters are standing by across the coast tonight. But first, Lily Greer begins our coverage.
If seeing is believing, you'd never guess the chaos we're being warned is coming our way. Townsville, a tropical paradise today, but soon to be ground zero for a widespread weekend of wild weather.
The state disaster management system is effectively planning for two events.
Tropical cyclone Kirrily is about to be born, barreling towards our coastline, predicted to make landfall late Thursday anywhere between Cardwell and Airlie Beach. But the latest tracking has it hitting between Townsville and Eyre, most likely as a Category 2 system. As Kirrily creeps closer, coastal communities could clock wind gusts of up to 150 kilometres per hour, bringing heavy rain and a dangerous storm tide as she crosses, and the threat of inundation from Townsville down to Mackay.
So the sea is likely to rise steadily up to a level well above the normal tide, with damaging waves and flooding of some low-lying areas.
Locals who live in low-lying areas and near waterways today braving scorching temperatures to protect their homes as best they can, taking no chances after what they went through in 2019. When floodwater swept through the city.
Not so much fear, but definitely need to prepare.
How many carloads of sandbags have you done today?
This is the third. That'll hopefully be our final. It's 10 per. It gets pretty heavy in there.
Once Kirrily's done with the north, she's expected to deliver a deluge to the south.
It will still have with it a significant amount of rainfall.
It's incredibly important that individuals and households prepare themselves.
A disaster stretching from one end of the state to the other. For emergency services, it's a case of divide and conquer.
We have our disaster response team, and then we've also got a strike team made up of Swiftwater technicians, mainly from the southeast corner, understanding that all the crews from up in this area already tied up.
Queenslanders tonight preparing for a big weather battle on more fronts than one.
Are you hoping that Kirrily is a bit of a fizzer, or do you think she'll be a big one?
I hope there's always hope, but you got to prep for the worst.
Well, let's go live to Townsville now. Lily, what's the latest on the mapping telling us?
Well, Andrew, the latest update we have from the Bureau includes a warning zone that stretches from Eyre south of Townsville all the way down to Mackay, and that includes Bowen and the Whitsunday Islands. Residents in those areas are being told to take precautions and to listen out for any advice that comes their way. Tonight, we are being told coastal communities could start to feel the impact of this system tomorrow afternoon. And as you just saw, plenty of personnel and resources from Queensland Fire and Rescue down south have just arrived in Townsville. Andrew, I can tell you there are more resources coming tomorrow morning to help out personnel up here who have already had such a busy summer.
Yeah, great to know these supporters on the way, Lily. Thank you. Well, let's go to weather expert Luke Bradnam. Now, you're in Bowen, Luke, and expecting some damaging winds there too.
Absolutely, Lofty. Yes, so we're expecting that cyclone to cross around 150 kilometres north of where I am this evening. But it's the southern side of the cyclone that sees the strongest of the winds. And those winds certainly starting to pick up this evening. You might be able to see behind me the white caps here in Bowen. Short time ago, just a gentle sea breeze. Right now, gusting up close to 50 kilometres an hour. Tomorrow, getting a whole lot stronger. In fact, a gale warning in place for Townsville and the Mackay coast tomorrow, with Kirrily. Though it's not just the winds we need to be concerned with, it's also the rain. And up on your screen at the moment, the expected rainfall totals across the state in the coming 7 days. Now, obviously the heaviest of the rain in the impact zone up here in North Queensland, but we will see drenching rain through the central interior, stretching through the Fraser coast and certainly through the southeast Queensland coast, Lofty, where we could see falls up to 200 millimetres. The whole of the state will be impacted in some way by Cyclone Kirrily, and of all the very latest, the full forecast live from Bowen a little later.
Talk to you soon, Luke. Thank you. Well, the southeast tonight is being warned to start preparing for that heavy rain. Peter Fegan is live for us at the SES in Morningside. Peter, evening to you. It's going to be a long-lasting event.
Well, Andrew, sadly, the warning to residents here in southeast Queensland is to prepare now. The bomb issued the warning this morning, stating that as Cyclone Kiralee crosses inland, it will then move south towards central and southern Queensland, bringing with it a significant amount of rainfall. Residents will experience similar scenes to what they did in far north Queensland recently when Tropical Cyclone Jasper crossed the coast. It's for that reason that authorities are now urging all residents to be prepared. Have a plan in place, Andrew. Prepare your house. Now, if you have any questions on what you need to do to prepare, the best advice is to engage with your local disaster management website or simply head over to the Get Ready Queensland website. You can also check in with your local council, Andrew, and where you can locate sandbags for both here in Brisbane and residents on the Gold Coast. Just a quick message for those on the Gold Coast, your sandbags will be ready on Thursday. Also, you can just chat to your neighbours and get yourselves ready. But the final message from authorities is we have, Andrew, just 48 to 72 hours to prepare for this event.
Time to act, Peter. Thank you. Well, Queensland is no stranger to wild weather, of course, and there are lessons that we can learn from over 100 years of severe storms. Tonight we take a look back as the state braces for Cyclone Kiralee and its aftermath.
Edward Street under 8 feet of water, whole West End houses washed away, ships run aground in the Botanic Gardens. This was the Great Flood of 1893.
It's really important that we document those events and so we can understand them better.
After a cyclone crossed the coast near Yeppoon and made its way south.
It was particularly destructive in the Brisbane area.
Fast forward to 1971, one of the most intense systems to ever hit Townsville makes landfall, Cyclone Althea crossing as a Category 3 on Christmas Eve.
It's beyond most people's memory.
The turning point for cyclone preparedness in Queensland.
We didn't have building codes and standards. Complete townships were decimated.
50 years ago tomorrow, Cyclone Wanda crossed near Maryborough, weak but slow-moving and dumping heavy rain that became the 1974 Brisbane floods.
History always repeats itself in one way or another.
Water everywhere. It was on a level I haven't seen.
Janita Ferris was just 8 years old, but the memories will never leave her.
The look of despair on people's faces, that there was so much that they've lost.
In more recent memory, few of us need to be reminded of the impacts of wild weather, the 2011 Queensland floods killing dozens. Just weeks later, Cat 5 Cyclone Yasi, the biggest storm in our history. 2017, Debbie devastating the Whitsundays. And just last month, floodwaters cutting off Cairns in the aftermath of Jasper.
We are progressively learning with each cyclone.
Lessons we will take with us as we stare down another cyclone this long weekend. Claire Todd-Hunter, Nine News.